Tommy Kings.
And here we are, back in the land of the long white cloud, Aotearoa, One Love Festival here in Tauranga.
And one of the things we love about being back in New Zealand is catching up with our musical peeps.
Dab.
That's right. So coming up next on Fresh TV.
Aloha. The One Love Festival this year is a little extra special because it's way, way bigger. Yeah.
You know what, we get to perform all over the world, but you know what, there's no place like Aotearoa.
We get to see fresh faces all over the world. Nobody, I mean nobody knows how to party like New Zealand.
That's right.
Getting hot in here, so take off all your clothes.
I didn't do my diet yet, so I'm not taking my clothes off.
And we got the whole baggage at One Love Festival. Yeah!
The first thing about One Love is the fresh music and the fresh people. It makes you want to dance. Makes you want to dance like this. If I ever tell you about Max.
And it's just about coming together and having a good time. One Love.
What's fresh about One Love? Look around you.
The freshest thing I've seen is the mean ass costumes. Just everyone dressing up, getting into it.
We made it ourselves, homemade.
Got it from the Vanuatu Islands.
Celebrating Bob Marley's birthday. It's awesome.
Bob Marley's brown? Will Brown? What are you laughing at, Jen?
Probably one of the things I love about reggae music, it's all about love.
Feeling that hits you inside, the heart, you know.
It just flows through us.
It's all about the love, heartache.
The One Love Festival this year is a little extra special because it's way, way bigger in terms of the production level and yeah, man, it's a big show.
Standing in the tree getting a free concert.
Keep it fresh!
So I grew up with reggae quite close. My father had a reggae band. And I was just to think why our people used to somehow always seem to equate to it. They always seem to be attracted to that type of music. And I just guess it's just because it's from Jamaica, you know what I'm saying? It's from poor people in Jamaica. I think poor people's music kind of just resonates with our people. I guess we're kind of like, you're predominantly poor, and I think that's possibly why we tend to relate to it. You got to wake up, got to get
out, got to get moving. Kind of reminds us of our roots, and it's all embedded. Island reggae is something that Polynesians created, so we took reggae and we brought our island flavor, and that's what it is, island reggae. So
absolutely love performing at One Love. It's such an honor and a privilege to be amongst such awesome artists. This is
Tomorrow People. Tomorrow People sound is a pretty much your typical New Zealand reggae sound, just a real mid-tempo kickback, just real positive music. It pretty much just reflects the character of all Pacific Islanders and Kiwis are living in. You give me something like nobody else, and something I only. What was the freshest thing about One Love is seeing like five people share one burger.
Huggy's nice. Me, Moldy. Me.
For a lot of people, this is kind of like a reggae festival to come see some bands. For people who work in the industry, it's kind of like a cool way to catch up with friends.
Take it easy and keep it fresh.
Man, that's a whole lot of love going on down here at the One Love Festival. We are Tomorrow People, and we're holding it down here. Grab some snacks, because straight after the break, you can hear a whole lot more about our brothers from the Pommer Kings. One love. I can take you to the kingdom, my
lady. Place you on the throne if you're ready. Welcome to my world, baby.
New Zealand's ready for our music, Pommer Kings, baby. One love.
Crow.
Oh.
Crow.
Ha.
Crow, we?
Crow up.
I already crow up.
When?
But a wicker crow.
Common
King. We're out here at the One Love Reggae Festival out here in Tauranga, feeling that good reggae vibes. We're bringing our vibes all the way from California to share with y'all. Sharing is caring, so check it out. We're about to share our world with you. Welcome.
See, we like to share.
Like our bed.
You can get it if you really want.
Pillow fight.
Succeed at last.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that was a great experience.
Can edit that out.
Yeah, how's your face?
Yeah, we'll okay. Talk about that later.
We're brothers first, you know, and then the music comes. That's what makes it so smooth, the chemistry.
Blood in, blood out. We're all like, you know,
shh.
Yep. We can edit that out too.
No, we don't have a day job. We haven't had a day job in what, 5 years?
5 years. Yeah, since we started, we all committed ourselves to the band.
Yeah, we're broke.
Yeah. Happily broke.
Happily broke. I'll tell you that right now.
We're definitely living the dream.
Oh, yeah.
Justin Timberlake was a big one for us. We learned so much from him and the whole team in so many ways, yeah.
That definitely started things off. And then after that, we went on tour with Fifth Harmony. They're like one of the craziest fans. I think when we went on tour with Fifth Harmony, that was ridiculous. Like pulling up to a venue and there's like a line of like 100 like screaming kids. That was an eye-opener.
The harmonizers, yeah. And all the girls had their own bodyguard, their own personal bodyguard.
We were as big as their bodyguards, actually.
Yeah.
We were just maybe. Like, don't worry, we got
cute stuff. Yeah, somebody tweeted, it's like, Common Kings think they're bodyguards now? Because, I don't know, I guess we weren't letting them talk to some of them. Yeah, we can edit that out.
But the whole coronation, that was very special. Especially for Jerome.
For Jerome. Yeah, first time there, brothers.
You're Tongan too, right?
Half Tongan. Half Superman.
They don't usually switch out kings very often, so
yeah.
Being able to be there for that was really cool. We got to meet Princess
Levu.
Yeah.
We had to wear, I thought, Valus, what is it?
Yep. Yeah, that was pretty cool. I look Tongan.
Yeah, you look pretty authentic.
Moi moi.
Moi moi.
Fui fui moi.
Fui fui moi. I can take it to the kingdom, my lady. Place you on the throne if you're ready.
Next to you because there is no other love. I'm not sure if it was a fan, it was more like a relative. JR was standing at the front of the stage, and man, she had the kung fu grip. And
oh, my
my leg.
And her leg and his leg, and
he couldn't.
He almost fell down.
She was so strong.
She was really strong.
Man, Tongan women, kung fu grip.
What? She was half.
But like a Tongan crazy. Someone strong with a Tongan crazy.
Welcome to my world, baby. Woo!
I think we get really caught up in the process of doing things that we don't really take that time to like reflect and like, holy crap, we just played in front of like the most people we've ever played in front of yesterday. And they were singing all our songs and they did the haka for us.
All the artists.
All the artists.
From the weekend, you know, they all came on stage and sang the song with us, so that was like, that was epic.
Yeah.
I don't think we'll get all those artists on the stage again.
We are lucky to share the stage with all these people yesterday, and then we have some great songwriters and producers that we're working with to make our music at that level to be with the rest of those A-listers on the Grammys. So we're excited to share that with you guys.
Breaking barriers, that's what we do. Common Kings, the way of life.
Oh yeah, man. Oh, my boys, Common Kings, I love them, that's my family. Hello, freshies, this is Fiji, right here in Tauranga for the One Love Festival on this beautiful day with this beautiful weather, and I know here, so many beautiful beaches right out here. So let me tell you, if you're interested, here's some tips for you.
And a welcome to the Island Tip. This week, our Island Tip is the many ways to wear a lava lava. Now, Kels, the most simplest way is just a side tie. You just wrap it around and you tie it at the hip. But if you want to make a more styly way, you do what we call a double hitch. You use the full drop of the lava lava and you tie on the side with the armpit and you tie on the side at the hip and it's look like two flower. Another way is a halter neck. The simpler way of this is just a straight halter. Once a cane come from the pack and then cross over in the front. Now, for the guy, it's not a lot of choice there, buddy. All you got is to come from the back and meet in the front, and you can do a center knot right in the middle where your belly pattern. Or the other way, come from the back and then cross over, and then you got two hitch on both hips. So you tuck in one side of the hip and tuck on the other side of the hip. But that's it for me this week. Tune in next week for more Prenny Advisors on the Island Tips.
Of course, we are here for the One Love Festival. My name is Sammy J. Stay tuned after the break because we have Auntie Tala and more freshness coming for you guys.
You know, especially for us, you know, island girls who have been blessed with curves, some more than others, you know.
I think you just got to smile and be proud and be fierce.
Reverse. Reverse.
Oh, so how do I get out the driveway, mate?
Oh, you just keep rolling back.
Rolling?
Rolling.
Rolling?
Rolling.
Rolling on the reverse.
Grimey, a reverse.
Oh, I was born by the reverse.
Hey. By the reverse of Babylon.
Yeah, but it's too far because I got many rivers to cross.
Oh. Yeah.
You know it's hard.
Okay, welcome back to Fresh. And man, we're just getting our reggae fixed on here, man. My name is Lucky Mariner. Getting off the stage of Brother Fiji here at One Love. It's going off, the sun is shining. You know what else makes me happy is when we listen to the beautiful sounds of our wahine. Coming up is Auntie Tala, and you better take her advice. Boom ba!
Kia ora. Hi, freshies, and welcome back to another episode of Tau Tala Tala. And today, I've got an amazing panel, all female, and I want to introduce them to you, starting off with our radio personality actress. She's everything in the Pacific. Please give it up for Yolandi Acha. Next, we have the amazing soulful voice forever entertaining our people, the diva of the Pacific, Annie Kramer. Now, the next generation of divas, we have the very beautiful and soulful voice of Nissa Kala. And now, let's go to our video message for today. And I must say, I can really relate to this one.
Okay, so the question is, ask this. As girls blessed with curves,
Eo.
Who should we take fashion advice from? Oh.
Eo, Eo. Should we take advice from a balangi?
Our balangi friends who say tight is right, or maybe our aunties who say dress for the body that
God has blessed us with.
Yeah, exactly. What do you reckon? Auntie Tala, help us out.
Do you ricks?
Wow, that's a really good question. You know, especially for us, you know, island girls who have been blessed with curves, some more than others, you know. But, well, what are your thoughts, Yolandi, about this face?
I like the curves, but I think you just got to smile and be proud and be fierce and shake your booty. If you walk down and you shake it and people fall into the side, who cares? It's your bum bum.
What about you, Annie? What do you think about that?
Oh, I love that. I wish I could be that confident. I mean, you know, but you do. When you wear something like a little bit saucy.
Saucy?
You gotta mean it. Ooh. Even if it means the help of some Spanx.
So it's something you put on and it makes
yes.
you...
Yes, size, wow. size 8. But where does it go?
Wow.
Where does it go when that thing just rolls? Where does
it go, Mama?
I think
if you put it up, everything comes up.
Hello.
And then you're like...
Got happy so
Papaya the Sailor Man. So, Nisha, do you use Spanx?
I don't think so, Atisala.
Well, what do you think about this question?
To be honest, I performed in a dress which was really tight. I guess it was my fault, you know, for not speaking up. So you have to speak up.
Oh, yeah, I remember when you wore that dress. You couldn't put the mic to your voice. Dad, I remember that. Well, talking about memories and times when things like that happen, I remember when I was at the beach and I wore a two-piece, just my sandals and my shades, and I was lying there trying to get a tan sand, and these people started to pour buckets of water on me and said, save it, save it. And then a tractor came and I was like, what are you doing? What are you doing? Anyway, let's get back to helping Pani and Pani. Starting with you, Lenny, what are some tools and tones to help Pani and Pani?
Do embrace a whole lot of colour, do use a whole lot of sex accessories, and don't, all you evil skinny people, don't stare, because that's really makwa disgusting.
Yeah, it's so not a short answer. It takes a long time for us Polynesians to grow out of the shyness to become more confident. Yes. But if you're just yourself, like Sister's saying, just go out there and rock and be you. Take advantage of the good lies. There are some good lies.
Thank you, Annie, for that.
No, hang on. There is a part B to this.
Oh, there is?
I don't want to leave it like that. And over to you, Nis.
Well, let's go, Nisa. What would you advise be tones and tones for Pani and Pani?
I say be comfortable, be yourself. Don't let anyone dress you, especially your sister, if she doesn't have any fashion sense.
Oh,
no. I love your curves.
Yeah.
Love your curves.
Yeah.
Yes, I love my curves.
Yeah.
Well, there you have it. You've heard it from our panel. But from me, all I have to say is that if you do have curves, you make them look nice, like a lot of colour, as Yolandi said. And also, you know, depending on what you wear and feel comfortable. But all I know is that when it comes to certain things like those shorts, you look like Hulk. You know, when Hulk go big, and then the shorts come right up and it's a rip. Be careful, don't wear those shorts if you look like a hog. So see you next week, same time, same place on Tau Tala Tala. Bye. Bye.
Baby, wrap it up.
Catch a fire. We're live and direct here at One Love. Check out this guy's Poly postcard. Kia ora, Freshies. I'm Johnson Rayella, and this is my Poly postcard from right here on my beautiful home island of Aitutaki Cook Islands. And I'm going to share with you a couple of my favourite things I love to do whenever I'm back home. A first must-do is jump on a boat and head out to one of Aitutaki's many beautiful motus on our world-famous lagoon for a spot of snorkeling, swimming and fishing. If you're lucky enough to visit Aitutaki when there's a wedding on, you'll witness a tradition we call Orotoroka. This is where the bride and groom ride around the island receiving gifts from locals. Hey! 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 lastly, nothing beats family time. We're actually right in the middle of our Katsu family reunion, and it's lunchtime. It's time to eat. That is my Poly postcard from right here in the beautiful Aitutaki Cook Islands, a place visitors have long nicknamed Heaven on Earth. Ka kite.
Function by telephone. Type of girl I like to fill a phone. Really wanna.
Yo, what up, it's your boy,
Common King.
And man, it was a great show. Super hot. All that.
Amazing. We just got done wrapping up One Love Festival with all these great people giving us sweet loving.
And speaking of sweet loving, next week on Fresh.
Hey, Freshies.
Morning. My name is Grace Rasmussen, and I'm from the Silver Ferns.
And I'm Kayla Cullen, and I'm from the Silver Ferns.
Though she a queen, and you know she never leave. They be waiting for a stumble, but she never trip again. The tenant, Flares, Ron.
It's so cool to have you here with us on Fresh. We're here at the Blue Rose Cafe in Okalani having some high tea.
Hell yeah.
That's us. So until next time, take care. We love you out there, all.
Let's get together and feel alright.
We love you very much.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.